idea is to have these special days, these holidays, and you two have had tragedy or loss, and you understand what they've been going through. What would we do without the Lord Jesus? We need to invite Him here to be with us today, also to invite Him to be a part of our lives, so each and every day to walk with Him. Let's go to the morning prayer right now. You know the Bible says, cast all your cares upon Him, because He cares for you. He truly does. Do we believe that this morning?
Amen.
Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father in heaven, we come before You, thanking the Lord for this wonderful day, Lord, a beautiful morning to be able to come out to Your house, Lord, and to worship You. Father, I can't think of any place I'd rather be than right here, worshiping You, O Lord Jesus. For You are the great one, Lord. You are the creator of all the universe, Father. You are everything. And Lord, as we lift You up and praise Your name, Father, invite Your presence here this morning, we ask that You'd come and be with us, Lord. But, Lord, we want to ask for forgiveness of our sin. We want You to cleanse us, Father, so that nothing will stand in the way of what You're trying to do, Lord, as You're working among us, Lord, as You're molding and making us more like You each and every day. Father, we want to thank You for all the many blessings, Lord, for just the blessings of life itself, for life. Lord, it's a good thing. And we thank You for it. Thank You for the very breath that we breathe. Now, Lord, as we come to the Lord, we want to lift up the Smith family. We want to pray for Kelly as she goes through surgery today. We pray, Lord, that for this Father, just comfort her by with Your Holy Spirit as only You can. That family, Lord, I don't know about the children and the grandchildren, but I know, Lord, that there's many in that family. For Danny and Margaret, as they travel back home today, Lord, as they're trying to hurry to get to their mom, pray, Lord, for their travel and safety. Now, Father, we just lift them up to You. Lord, we want to pray for Carmen today. We pray that You just continue to be with her as she goes through her treatments, Lord. We thank You, Father, that she was able to eat more and her appetite was getting better. We just pray You continue to be with her, Lord. Lord, there are many, many in our church family here, Lord, that we just need to lift up. And so, Father, we just pray, Lord, as Your word says, we lay all these cares down, Lord, because You care for us. We want to pray in faith that You'll answer these prayers. We thank You for that. We thank You, Lord, for this day that's been recognized to remember those who have given their lives and sacrifice for this country. We thank You for their service. Lord, bless this time. Make Your presence known here in a special way. So when we leave this place, we can truly say we've been in the house of the Lord. For we love You because of Your great love for us. And it's in Jesus' precious and holy name we pray. Everybody say it.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to take just a moment here this morning. And, you know, I just want to, I love our veterans, those who have served in the military. You know, we wouldn't enjoy the freedoms that we have today had it not been for those who gave their lives in service to this country. You know, if you served in any kind of military capacity, or if you're serving right now, you know, we wanted to say thank you to you. Would you just stand up for a moment? Anyone who is a servant. So let me ask you. You see these men and women that have served, let's give them just a thank you.